Hey everyone, this is Scott from certmedia.com, and in this video I'm going to be showing you a very, very new plugin that just came out. I just purchased it, an unlimited site license. I'll probably use it on some of my client sites and sites that I build, and it's called Novashare. It is made by the same team who made Perf Matters, which I already did a video on. I'll put that up here in the little eye thing. It's meant to be a very, very, very lightweight and yet also feature-rich plugin. One of my common gripes with sharing plugins are they tend to be quite bulky. And Social Warfare, as I talked about in its video, I wrote a specific plugin that removes some of the junk that it adds, notably its usage of font files. So it uses a WAF2 file. And it loads its assets on every page indiscriminately, and those were issues that I initially had with it. This plugin is really small. It's a very, very minimal amount of CSS, and that's why I just thought I had to have it right away. I like to have things as clean and lightweight, but allows me to have enough flexibility to use it how I want. So one of the things that you're going to see right off the bat is this plugin doesn't seem to load anything until you enable it. So we're going to just turn on the inline content for the post. So what this does is allows you to have your share buttons. You can enable it to be inline, floating, or a click to tweet feature, which allows you to use the block editor to basically put a quote in a box that when they click it, it'll tweet that, and you can use your at handle to get more Twitter followers. I'm a big fan of features like that. As you can see, it supports Facebook, Twitter, LinkedIn, Pinterest, Buffer, so on and so forth. It supports all of the major networks that I would hope. The one thing I do wish is that it supported some of the non-English related platforms, something like there's a Russian social network that I'm not even gonna try to pronounce it. It's like, oh no, something another. And then they do not have support for Sina Weibo, which is a Chinese social network, kind of like Twitter, but more like Facebook. I wish that they added support for that, just so that way they target international users a little bit better. But it's got about as many options, and some of them are more than you even find in Social Warfare Pro. We will be doing a comparison with Social Warfare, the light version, from a performance point of view here in just a minute, though. So you turn this on, and we're just having the most basic configuration. You'll open up your post, and it adds it over here in the footer. Looks really good. And you can enable and disable any of them as you wish, and you can drag them in any order that you wish as well. You can define a mobile breakpoint, which is where the buttons will start treating the device as a mobile device. That's very flexible, and it allows you to modify things like the floating bar for mobile-only users. You could choose to hide the content above a certain breakpoint. So depending on your breakpoint here, if you enable this, it will hide this content if the screen is larger than 1200 pixels in width. So if I enable this, I expect these buttons to go away, and it does. Or you could choose to hide it below that width right there. This is a little bit confusing because you're able to check both these options, which doesn't really make a lot of sense to me. If you're gonna have an option to hide it at the above and below breakpoint, those options should have some sort of logic that just says if one of these is checked, the other one can't be checked, because then it's not gonna display at all. But it exists as options here. You could choose your button size as small, medium, and large. And then you could choose your button shape to be squared, rounded, or circular. If you're curious what they look like, here is the circular option. It looks just like a circle. They look really good. There is the rounded option, which is basically just a square option with rounded off corners. And it also looks really good. There is no real large horizontal one like you see in the Social Warfare, where it takes up the whole space. And I think that's in part due to the amount of buttons you can have. I also imagine that it'll be added down the line. This plugin just came out this month, like a couple days ago. So as soon as I saw it, and I'm like, ooh, this looks really promising, and I would use this. And then you could change the button colors, the hover colors to fit your brand styling through here. And then you have a total share count, which allows you to display the total share count for your social share buttons. When you share it to a platform, I'm just gonna click and then delete. It should start incrementing a counter. Now, we're gonna get to share counters here in a minute. Personally though, I have to say, I'm not that big of a fan of share counters. Some people are, but I personally don't use them. But I'm going to show you them because a lot of people do like to use it. The floating bar is exactly like the rest of the options. You enable this, and it's a bar that floats. You could choose to float it over here onto the left-hand side. This looks very much like Add This. Add This is a JavaScript-based platform. You just paste the JS on your site, and you're allowed to customize and change how it loads. So it looks really good. I'm super impressed with how easy it is to get this thing up and running. And if you're on mobile, we're just going to simulate a Galaxy S5 here. As you can see, it now is a button that floats at the bottom of the screen. So you could, if you knew a little bit of custom CSS, you could go ahead and make it look like it's a floating bar relatively easily, or you could just add enough social share buttons like this. One thing that's a little odd, in my opinion, is the real lack of a background color option for the floating bars. I feel like that should definitely be included, because users are going to be using this as a floating bar in the footer. And if you're just using this setting, you can't quite tell how to do that. You could change button color and the hover color. Then you have the click to tweet. I'll show you what this looks like. So we're gonna edit this post here that came with default with WordPress. You'll click edit. And then we're going to just go to the bottom. And when we get to the bottom, we're going to the Novashare click to tweet. And then you type in whatever you want. Hello world. It tells you the amount of characters remaining, because remember with Twitter, you can only use 280 characters. And then it's gonna have your at symbol as well. Your call to action, you could choose to change it from the click to tweet to whatever you wish. And then you could choose to remove your username if you so wish, or to remove the URL. You could change the styling to be more in line with your brand. So you can either use the gray background or transparent, or the blue native Twitter background. Personally, I will just be using the blue background because I like it to look more in line with Twitter branding instead of the website's branding. You could choose to hide hashtags if you so wish, and really simple and straightforward. So if you now come over to this post, scroll down to the bottom, you get this nice little click to tweet. We'll click it, we'll have it pop up, and it says hello world, and it's linking to this post. Now you might be wondering, well, that's great, but how do I make it tweet at me? This is where you get your configuration settings. Under the configuration, you can make a couple of changes. You can enable your share counter here using TwitCount. TwitCount is a third-party share API. Remember that Twitter did away with its native share counter API many years ago. And you can also set a minimum share count threshold to prevent showing the share count until you've reached a certain amount. There is currently not a way to fake a share count, which is where you just inflate the numbers and then count off incrementally from that. But I imagine that it will exist in the future. You could choose to enable the Facebook Open Graph data. If you're using something like Yoast SEO, make sure you disable this. And then you're gonna include your Twitter username. So I'm just gonna put this at Scott T. Hartley, which is my personal Twitter handle. And we're gonna now go back to over here, and I'm gonna demonstrate what happens. When you click this, it now says via at Scott T. Hartley. So it's doing the information for your click to tweet from this section. If you use the native share buttons, it will also tweet at your username. That's an ideal configuration. In my mind, you should have it tweet at you to expand your reach when somebody shares your content. You could go ahead and choose to insert your Facebook app ID and app secret ID for setting up your shares share counter from Facebook. And then you could choose to use their Open Graph data as we just covered. You could choose to purge all share counts. You should only do this if you're trying to debug something. If you do this, it probably will just reset your counter back to zero until it goes ahead and calls the API again for like the Twitter count. And then you can enable Google Analytics UTM parameters. If you're trying to track your share information via Google Analytics, you can set this up here. I'm not gonna show you how to do that because that could be quite time consuming, but for the sake of this, you have the ability to do it. You can enable link shortening via Bitly. Bitly is a free freemium URL shortener. You'll just insert your access token here, and you could just include a subset of grouping links. You would just set your group in Bitly to something like social or share buttons, so that way you're subsetting them from the ones you generate from the ones that users are generating from sharing your post. Then under the tools, you could just choose to do a clean uninstall, which is where it deletes all data that Novashare has in the database when you deactivate and uninstall it. And there's an accessibility mode, which disables the use of visual UI elements such as checkboxes and hovering tooltips. That's good if you have to use a screen reader. This just makes it easier on those who have more difficult times accessing content hidden behind hovers. So now the real reason that people are probably here is to figure out, well, how does this compare to social warfare? So to demonstrate this, what we're going to do is I'm going to enable the floating buttons, and I'm only going to be doing it on the post page because that's the page we're going to be measuring. Everything else on these sites are exactly the same. They're running the same version of WordPress. They're running the same themes. They both have all caching disabled except for the native browser caching, but because we're using GT Matrix, that does not matter. I'm going to enable the share counter because that's what I have on the other one. And I'm going to enable the 5 free buttons they give you over here. And I have 7 over here, which won't matter too much. And we're going to just leave it at that. That should give us a very good amount of... Here, we'll do this on the left-hand side just so that way we're completely equal. I'm not going to bother putting in the Twitter username, and I'm not going to bother adding the... any other sub options here because they won't really impact it. And then we're just going to make one edit, and we're going to also add a Twitter card into this post because it's the same post. And we're just wanting to demonstrate how equal they are. So you have to just type your tweet, then type your tweet that you want to display on Twitter, type the quote that you want to display on the page. And we're going to just send it at the default because that's what we have the other one as. And then we're going to go ahead and update, and I'm just going to verify that this is indeed loading how I want it to. I'm going to turn off full screen mode because that's obnoxious. That was the worst decision in 5.3. And looks good. All right. We now have basically the exact same configuration. Looks like I have Novashare only in the, I'll put them on the above and below options. So now they're totally equal. Minus the additional share buttons in this floating one. So the goal here is we're going to test both these URLs in GT Matrix. We're not so much looking for load time as we are looking for page weight, because that's really what's going to matter. There's going to be all kinds of issues with the server response time and network response time because we're not using any sort of caching or optimization. But we're just wanting to get a baseline understanding to see what the difference is between these two plugins. I already know which one's going to win, but the audience may not. So we're going ahead and running this. All right, so we have 388 kilobytes with 18 requests. And over here, we have 412 kilobytes and 21 requests. That's pretty substantial, especially for the same functionality. This comes down to a couple of reasons that we're gonna have to discuss, but let's just look for the actual Novashare assets. It loads two assets, a CSS file that measured 1.4 kilobytes. This is gzipped. This is not using Brotli. And it is using 809 bytes of JavaScript. Meanwhile, Social Warfare is loading, and we're just going to separate it again by looking for Social, which is going to only list Social Warfare assets. They're loading the CSS for... Actually, they're loading a JavaScript. Their URL structure doesn't make any sense. This is a CSS file, though. For, I'm assuming this is their click to tweet button. No, this is... I'm not quite sure what they have going on there. They have 9.6 kilobytes for their main CSS file. So 9.6 kilobytes, and this one's 1.4. It's around 4 times as large. Their main JavaScript file is 4.9 kilobytes. That's almost like 6 times larger than this one. And then finally, their icon font is 8 kilobytes. You'll notice that Novashare is not loading an icon font. The reason for that is Novashare uses inline SVG icons. So if you just hover over this asset, and you'll see that it's declaring an inline SVG asset. What that basically means is they're giving parameters for the browser to physically draw the icons here, as opposed to having them download an image or a font file to load them. This is more performant in this kind of application, and it really does show. It should also totally work with any of the standard lazy loading plugins because it's an SVG icon. It's not loading via an image source. You shouldn't notice any unusual issues. I tested it with WP Rocket and I didn't run into any issues using the configuration I did in that video. But really, this is an awesome plugin. Just the only change between these two is the total page size is 388 kilobytes for Novashare and 412 kilobytes for Social Warfare. And that doesn't sound like a lot, but you have to realize that there are some other tweaks going on in the background. For instance, on the Novashare, if we look for the plugin assets, they're only loading, let's see, the JavaScript on the home page. And I'm not quite sure why they're loading it on the home page. It's probably to handle this click to tweet functionality. But really, it's just substantially less. It would be a noticeable improvement if you were running something like PageSpeed Insights. We'll go ahead and run it too, just to kind of demonstrate. This is not a perfect scientific test here, because we are gonna have to deal with Flexit with slightly different variations in the TTFB. But this is a really, really lightweight plugin, guys. You're not going to find another plugin that is as lightweight as this. I did a comparison with the Genesis Simple Share, which only offers like four social networking options, and it still outweighed it. This is the lightest social sharing plugin that I've managed to find when I was testing. We get a 95 here. That doesn't really mean much because there's not really a lot going on. And we get a 94 over here. And again, that's within the margin of error because these sites are not technically optimized as they are. But really, you're saving, look at it, like 40 kilobytes or so in page size. You're knocking out three requests. They're going to render faster because of the inline SVGs. It's just an overall better plugin. I also like the fact that instead of Social Warfare, which adds a top level item in my admin bar, which always bugs me when plugins add something here when they're not really needed, this one adds it underneath your settings and your share buttons. Now, this isn't a completely fair test. Social Warfare Pro actually does weigh a bit more because it's loading more assets and it's a little bit bulkier. But even still, we're comparing a premium share plugin over here with more options, with more share buttons enabled, and we're still getting substantially less on the page size front. Overall, if you're looking to pay for a share button plugin and you want something that's going to be really lightweight, I would honestly highly suggest Novashare at this point. The developers, I tweeted at them before I purchased the plugin, and I asked I mentioned some with Perf Matters as well. There's going to be some integration with Perf Matters at some point down the line. I'm not really sure in what form that's going to come. Perf Matters is also going to be getting some additional features in the future for managing inline CSS. That's good to hear. But really, this is definitely the plugin I'm going to be using. I'm going to be swapping my sites over to it. I bought myself an unlimited site license, and honestly, I'm going to be very pleased with it. If you have any questions about this plugin, maybe some feature that you're not sure if it's covered or not, please feel free to ask in the comments below. Otherwise, thank you all so much for watching, and goodbye.